We're in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning. We are talking taste trekkers with Chef Cesin from Los Andes Restaurant. We're making trio de ceviche.
Correct, my friend.
So you are back. Taste trekkers is what we're talking about, not necessarily the restaurant. We're going to get into that because that alone is a great, great event that's going to be happening.
Correct. This event is going to take place in the month of September. It's a three-day event starting on the 20th, ending on the 23rd. We have a great cocktail reception at the Dorrance on Friday. Mm-hmm. Then it's going to be followed on Saturday the 21st at the Biltmore. We have Chef Matt Jennings who's going to be holding a session. He's going to be discussing from cuisines from different regions. Then at the Pavilion Inn, we have a great meeting with all chefs from the city.
Right.
We have wine tasters, distillers, distributors. So, I mean, if you enjoy dining in wine.
And great food.
Correct.
That is the place. That's the thing
to
do.
You're going to go right behind the scenes and see how everything's made. Get to meet the chefs. Get to meet the distributors.
All
and
good.
Hands on. And it'll be a perfect event. It's going to be the event of the year, I believe.
All good stuff. We're going to give you more information about that, too, in just a little bit. But first, let's get to what we're going to be making and go over the ingredients we need for this dish.
So we have the corvina, which is actually a fish. It can be substituted for any white meat fish that you enjoy. Mm-hmm. We have a trio of peppers. Once again, you can play around with anything. We have jalapenos, we have ají limo, and a ají amarillo. These are native peppers from Peru.
Right.
A little bit of garlic, cilantro, and salt, and lime. Very simple, very fresh. And that's what's going to make our trio ceviche this morning.
And is this one of the favorite dishes that you like making at the restaurant itself?
Ceviche is the way to go, a Los
Andes. That's the way to go.
That's the main dish. Everybody that loves the restaurant, they really, truly enjoy our ceviche.
Okay.
And this is one of six ceviches that we have in our menu.
Very good. All good stuff. We're going to put everything together in just a little bit. And we are going to be talking more about the Taste Trekkers event that's going to be happening here, right here in Rhode Island. All that information coming up, but back to you.
Yeah, that's right. Taste Trekkers has actually brought in Los Andes. Once again, Chef Cesin is here. We are making three different types of ceviche. Is that right?
Correct. We're going to be doing a trio de ceviche. Mm-hmm. We're going to be showcasing the difference that a pepper makes in the ceviche.
Okay.
So we're going to start off first with a little bit of salt. What I'm going to do is I'm going to get all the fish ready for you. And all you're going to do is add a little of that lime and mix it right in.
Okay.
So what we have here is the corvina. This fish is actually... like we were just talking a couple of minutes ago, it's very similar to a weak fish or a sea trout.
Mm-hmm.
It can be done with any other white meat fish that you may have at home.
Okay.
So after the salt, we're gonna add a little bit of garlic. As you can see, it's a very simple components that we're throwing onto our ceviche.
Yes.
It's pretty much a salt, garlic, the cilantro, and of course the lime juice. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna add a little bit of the cilantro.
And the thing about ceviche is you eat it just like this.
Correct.
There is no real cooking to it.
Well, there's a couple styles of ceviche that we have. I mean, what we do have is the Central American style ceviche and the South American style ceviche. Central American ceviche is going to be where the fish is left overnight or for a couple of hours. In this type of ceviche, we actually almost like a sashimi where the fish is pretty much raw. What we do is we towel dry the fish right before slicing it.
Okay.
So this way all the flavors absorb and penetrate right through it.
Beautiful.
All right, so now we're going to start off with the green one.
Okay.
You can put it in the first mix bowl.
How much? What is this here?
This is actually a jalapeno puree. We just put it through the food processor, and that's a perfect amount.
Okay.
We're going to follow it with the yellow. We're going to try to do the same amount in the corvina.
Right. And this one is?
This is ají amarillo. This can be substituted for a habanero.
Okay.
Once again, all these peppers are divine and deseeded, so there's miles down. And this is ají limo. This is actually the jalapeno's cousin.
Is this the hottest one?
The hottest.
I feel like red always means hot.
Yeah, I mean, fire, yellow.
Okay. They all got a kick,
but the strongest one would be the ají amarillo, which is the yellow pepper.
Which is the yellow one.
Yep. So
I want to try it.
Good luck.
Good luck?
Oh my God, huh? You must like spice.
Well, we'll see in a minute. Tastes fine for now.
All right.
I may be needing some water in just a little bit. All right, we've got our ceviche started. Right. There's three different kinds. We're going to finish them up a little later in the show, guys.
Taste Trekkers is the event. Chef Cesin's here from Los Andes Restaurant. Trio de Ceviche is what we are making, and we're talking about the Taste Trekkers event, which is a great event for anybody who really loves food and wine and just a great time in the city of Providence.
I mean, the goal that we want to do with this event is we want people to walk out of this event discovering a new place to dine,
mm-hmm.
or a new experience in general, a new cuisine they never explored
right.
yet.
Because so many people get stuck in that rut. They go to the same restaurant mm-hmm. every week. They never
venture
out.
The same dish. They don't even ask for the menu.
Nope. I know what I want.
And mm-hmm. one of those things, too, is, I mean, one of the great things about Providence is the diversity. Mm-hmm. We have so many restaurants
sure.
in Rhode Island. And that's this is a great way to expose all these places that sometimes, like you mentioned, you know, people just are stuck going to this one place. Once you go there, you meet the chefs, you meet the distributors,
right.
you meet the brewers and whatnot. This is where you get to really feel and see the hard work that is behind
make
all these
a connection.
Restaurants.
Right.
Correct, definitely.
Because restaurant business is not easy.
Yeah, it's not easy. You have to love it.
Yeah.
You have to love
right.
it. And that's what it's all about, is loving what you do. So, I mean, this is one of the things that we're going to be presenting at the Taste Trekkers.
Okay.
On the 20th, we have a cocktail reception that's going to be held in the Dorrance.
Mm-hmm.
On the 21st, we have Chef Matt Jennings, who's going to be talking a little bit about different cuisines from different regions.
Award-winning chef,
yep.
too. He's,
amazing.
He's a great person
amazing.
To chat with.
Amazing. He's one of the best chefs in Rhode Island. He is the best chef in Rhode Island, I believe. Then we're going to have the rest of the chefs and food vendors are going to be demonstrating their products. And along with ourselves, we're going to be there showing and doing our ceviche. So it's an event that you really don't want to miss out. So later on, in that same afternoon at the Marriott, you're going to have Gail Campos, who's going to be discussing a couple things in regards to the different cuisines.
Sure.
Uh-huh.
Later on that evening as well, you're going to be doing the water fire. It's a great way to finish off.
Nice
night.
Right.
Oh,
yeah.
What a nice
yeah,
night.
Sure.
And spend the whole night in Providence.
And Sunday, the last day, it's actually going to be the food truck brunch. So this way, it's a great way to see that once again, this is an upcoming thing. A lot of
yep.
Food trucks
that
I'm pretty
they
sure you
all
see
over,
all
yeah.
over the place.
You're just going to feast for days.
Right, yeah.
I
correct.
Love it.
And I mean, that's what it's all about. I mean, for more information, for tickets, you can just go
yep.
to tastetrekkers.com and get any information you might need.
Okay, good.
So
very
to finish
good.
Off
great
our ceviche here, we're going to do is... Is it the red one is the spiciest one? You were right.
Come on, Will.
Okay.
Oh
red.
My God, I can't believe
it. He said it was spicier than the yellow, which
no.
I found not bad.
Okay, there you go.
All right.
This one will give you a little bit of a kick.
This one will, yeah?
Yeah. For sure.
Yep.
Right?
Does it really? Really? Can I try?
Thank you.
Can I try?
Thank you so much.
Yeah,
help yourself.
Yes, please go ahead.
Okay, all right, let's give it a shot here.
Go ahead.
That's the limo.
You can do it.
But that's one of the things, though, when you have these peppers and you complement them with the citrus from the lime, it kind of, you want a spoonful of lime?
Yo!
Whoa.
Woo.
All right. So
wow.
That's got a kick.
Hang on.
That's got a kick. But if you guys are tempted to try it once again with the
sure.
lime and the ingredients, it's actually, you're going to notice that it's a little bit mellowed. So this is the
I
way.
I think I burned all of my taste buds off.
I'm all not right. sure I have a tongue anymore.
That's why it's usually good to get a good beer chaser for this appetizer.
But in terms of having a kick, you said, of course, the red one is the hottest.
Correct.
Go down, what, red, yellow, then green? I mean, we always know jalapeno as being hot.
Well, this is kind of like a street sign, you know? You have the red to tell
yep.
you to stop, you know?
Whoa.
Apparently, we missed that.
The green is a go, and the yellow slow down. You know what I mean? But it's that's like pretty
well,
much how they go.
Well, you know what they say, Ronan? You see yellow, you speed up.
You just
go
speed
right through
up.
Red.
Yeah, exactly.
Don't worry about red. Don't wait for wet red. Just go right through.
So,
although we now have our hot street cred.
Yeah.
If there is such a thing.
No,
wow,
but
that's
what it is. I mean, if you complement this with a great Sauvignon Blanc
yeah.
or a great
mm-hmm.
beer, I mean,
yeah.
you won't be running into the bathroom and you know, running your mouth through the faucet.
I have to say, it's handleable, though. You can
yeah.
tell once
correct.
It hits that lime juice and you have the fish and mm-hmm. the other different ingredients in there, the presentation alone is really beautiful, too. So you
definitely.
Can share this with someone.
Of course.
And each get a little taste.
And this right here is actually concha. I almost forgot to talk about our friend concha here. This is a roasted corn.
Okay.
This actually adds a lot of texture to our ceviche.
It looks like corn nuts.
That's pretty much what it is. It's a nice corn nut. Once again, it's imported from Peru.
That's not spicy.
Not spicy.
And it takes away a little
like
bit of spice. So, well, we hope that you all can make it to the Taste Trekkers on the 20th. It's going to be a wonderful
that's
event.
Good.
Believe me, I know it's going to be the event of the year. If you love
sounds
food,
so
I think that's a place for to be
okay.
for that weekend.
We love food. We'll give you shots of that red sauce over there and see who can
have another drink.
First. This really is delicious, though. And if you want this recipe, you can find it for yourself on our website. It's the Roadshow page at WPRI.com.